Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is SAARC, that is South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, and ASEAN, that is Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Relevance of this topic with respect to RBI Grade B will be in Phase 2, Paper 2, Economic and Social Issues under Regional Economic Cooperation topic. With regard to NABARD, Grade A and Grade B will be in Phase 1, Economic and Social Issues, Phase 2, Paper 2, Economic and Social Issues under Regional Economic Cooperation topic. SAARC is a regional intergovernmental organization of 8 South Asian nations, founded on 8th December 1985 with the aim of welfare of people of South Asia, having secretariat located at Kathmandu, Nepal. Important point to note here from exam point of view is that year of formation, number of member countries and the location of its secretariat. Main idea of cooperation in South Asia was discussed in various conferences as mentioned here. You should have an idea of these conferences, where they were held and when. There is no need to go deep in this. After a gap of around 26 years, President of Bangladesh, Zia-ur-Rahman, made proposal for cooperation in South Asia on 2nd May 1980. And finally, SAARC was established on 8th December 1985 in Dhaka, Bangladesh. Very, very important point to note here is that there were 7 founding members of SAARC. Afghanistan joined the group later in 2007. This slide shows all the members and observers of SAARC. Remember all its members and observers. Following are the main aims and objectives of SAARC, like welfare of people, economic growth, maintaining peace, strengthening cooperation, etc. in South Asia. SAARC has been divided into 6 wings for its smooth functioning. These are Council, Council of Ministers, Standing Committee, Programming Committee, Technical Committee and Secretariat. Council is the apex policy making body of SAARC, represented by head members of countries which meet once in 2 years. It is assisted by Council of Ministers, which are represented by foreign ministers of member countries. Standing Committee is comprised by foreign secretariats of member governments and Programming Committee by senior officials. Programming Committee performs mainly financial related functions like scrutinizing the budget, financing, annual schedule, etc. Technical Committee is comprised by representatives of member governments. Last and most important arm of SAARC is the Secretariat. As explained earlier, it is located in Kathmandu, Nepal. Secretary General is the head of Secretariat, which is appointed by the Council of Ministers. Secretariat perform all the major functions like monitoring SAARC activities, servicing SAARC meetings, etc. You should remember all its 6 wings and the members they are comprised of. This table shows various regional centers of SAARC and their location. Remember all these from exam point of view. Very important slide describing SAARC first summit and its recent summits. Remember the year and country where they were held. Another point to remember is that 19th SAARC summit was scheduled to be held in 2016 in Pakistan, but was cancelled after India refused to participate in it because of terrorist attack on India's military base located in Uri, Jammu and Kashmir. There are several factors which are hindering the SAARC to achieve its goals and objectives, like tension between India and Pakistan, cross-border terrorism, low human development index and persistent problem of poverty, illiteracy, health, flood, etc. Another important topic for today's discussion is ASEAN, that is Association of Southeast Asian Nations. ASEAN is an international organization established on 8th August 1967 with 5 founding members with the aim to accelerate growth, development, security in Southeast Asia. Other 5 members joined the group later, with Brunei became first to join it in 1984 and Cambodia became the last. Remember all its 5 founding members and other members and their year of joining. 3 countries, that is Philippines, Federation of Malaya and Thailand, formed a group called Association of Southeast Asia on 31st July 1961, which later expanded to form ASEAN on 8th August 1967 by signing ASEAN Declaration, which is popularly known as Bangkok Declaration. This is a very important point to note. Treaty of Amity and Cooperation was signed in ASEAN's first summit held in 1976 in Bali, Indonesia, which contains the fundamental principles adopted by ASEAN. To give the group a legal status, all 10 members signed ASEAN Charter in 2007, which entered into force on 15th December 2008. Another important point to remember is the composition of ASEAN plus 3 and ASEAN plus 6. ASEAN plus 6 is also known as Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, that is RCEP, which is proposed to be signed in ASEAN Summit of November 2018. This slide shows all 10 member countries of ASEAN. It will be quite easy to remember them as per their geographical location. Now comes basic things about ASEAN, like its motto, flag, headquarters, etc. ASEAN flag contains mainly red, blue, white and yellow color, with each color having its unique significance. Remember the significance of all its color, stalk of padi in center and circle. Also remember the title of ASEAN anthem, which day is observed as ASEAN Day, and where the headquarters of ASEAN is located. As told in earlier slide, Treaty of Amity and Cooperation was signed during ASEAN's first summit held in Bali, Indonesia in 1976, which contains the fundamental principles adopted by ASEAN as mentioned in the slide. No need to remember these, just have a brief idea of its principles. Very important slide mentioning ASEAN's first summit and the recent summits. Remember the year and the host country. 32nd ASEAN Summit is proposed to be held in Singapore on 25th to 28th April 2018. MCQs are for practice and are based on the content discussed so far. Kindly solve them for better understanding. Thank you and happy learning.